Welcome back to our channel where we explore the biggest events in history that have shaped our world. Today, we're diving into one of the most devastating environmental disasters that have left a lasting impact on our planet, the biggest oil spills in history. Humans have used petroleum, or oil, for thousands of years in medicine and weapons of war. However, the use of this material did not truly surge until the Industrial Revolution, where oil became valuable as both a fuel for illumination and a lubricant, before it became a replacement for wood, coal, animal power, and other sources of energy. Liquid petroleum had some significant advantages over other energy sources of the times. It was concentrated, and it could be transported easily from one place to another. As oil use boomed, its refined products, such as gasoline and diesel, came to be used to fuel automobiles, ships, and other vehicles, and a worldwide system of wells, ships, storage terminals, and pipelines grew. As a result of old and damaged equipment, human error, and bad luck, extracting oil from the ground and moving it to refineries and beyond occasionally releases oil into the environment. The largest spills have released tens of millions of gallons of oil and have resulted in fouled coastlines, polluted fisheries, dead and injured wildlife, and lost tourism revenue. The top 9 most destructive oil spills are listed below. The Amoco Cadiz Oil Spill, 1978. The Amoco Cadiz, a very large crude carrier, VLCC, stocked with nearly 69 million gallons of light crude oil, ran aground on shallow rocks off the coast of Brittany, France, on the morning of March 16, 1978. The ship was navigating the rough seas of the English Channel when its rudder and hydraulic system were damaged by a large wave. Rescue tugs attempted to secure tow lines to the Cadiz, but sea conditions made the operation difficult. The first of the tow lines broke only a few hours after being secured. By the time a second line could be attached, the Cadiz had been driven by winds and waves toward the Brittany coast, where the stern and midsection clipped shallow underwater rocks. The impact slashed holes in the hull and container tanks and released the oil. About 200 miles, 321 kilometers, of French coast was polluted by the oil slick, which killed millions of invertebrates, such as mollusks and crustaceans, and an estimated 20,000 birds, and contaminated oyster beds in the region. In 1990, Amoco Corporation, the owners of the Cadiz, agreed to pay $120 million to French claimants, along with an additional $35 million to Royal Dutch Shell, which had owned the lost oil. The Castillo de Bellver oil spill, 1983. A fire aboard the oil tanker Castillo de Bellver in August 1983 was responsible for the tanker's capsizing. When the fire broke out on August 6, the Castillo de Bellver was located in the South Atlantic Ocean roughly 70 miles from Cape Town, South Africa. The tanker drifted and broke into two pieces. Its stern section, which contained some 110,000 tons of oil, drifted to within 24 miles of the coast before it sank in deep water. The tanker's forward section was towed away from the coast, where engineers used explosives to sink it. Although a portion of the oil slick burned during the fire, the majority of the oil released at the surface was caught in the Benguela Current and carried out to sea before it dispersed, so the spill caused little environmental damage. Some sources place the tanker's load at some 53.5 million gallons of crude oil. However, many sources note that the tanker was carrying 79 million gallons of crude oil when the fire started. The incidents at the Nowruz Oil Field, 1983. On February 10, 1983, an Iranian oil platform above the Nowruz Oil Field in the northern Persian Gulf was struck by a tanker. The impact caused the platform to list 45 degrees, and corrosion and wave energy worked to topple the platform and rupture the platform's wellhead. The well leaked about 1,500 barrels, 63,000 gallons, of oil into the Persian Gulf per day before it was finally capped in September 1983. During the early 1980s, the northern Persian Gulf was a contested war zone as part of the Iran-Iraq War, and a different nearby platform was attacked by Iraqi helicopters only 1 month after the tanker collision. The damage to this second platform spilled some 733,000 barrels, about 31 million gallons, of oil into the Gulf before it was capped more than 2 years later. Iran's capping and repair operations were performed under fire from the Iraqis, and some 20 people died trying to cap the wells. Estimates suggest that roughly 80 million gallons of oil were spilled as a result of these two incidents. Skimmers and other equipment were able to clean up some of the oil, but an estimated two-thirds of the total amount fell to the seafloor as tar balls after sand mixed with floating oil at the surface. The Kolva River Spill, 1994. The Kolva River oil spill was caused by a breach in a corroded oil pipeline in the Russian Arctic. Oil pooled around the rupture site for 8 months, contained by a dike, but the dike later gave way, spilling roughly 84 million gallons of oil into the Kolva River. Some 186 square kilometers, about 72 square miles, of tundra and wetlands were tainted by oil. Oil leaks from pipelines in the region continued to release millions of gallons of oil into the landscape, some of which reached the Kolva River. The Mingbulak, or Fergana Valley, Oil Spill, 1992. The largest land-based oil spill in history, and Asia's worst oil spill, occurred in Uzbekistan on March 2, 1992. A blowout at a well spewed oil into the valley near the city of Fergana. The oil caught fire and burned for 2 months before the well pressure subsided. Of the estimated 88 million gallons that were released, more than 88 million gallons were protected from fire behind berms and dikes. The Atlantic Empress Oil Spill, 1979. The Atlantic Empress disaster released an estimated 90 million gallons of oil into the Atlantic Ocean some 16 kilometers, 10 miles, off the islands of Trinidad and Tobago. The collision between the VLCC's Atlantic Empress and Aegean Captain on July 19, 1979, during a tropical storm created the largest tanker spill on record. Both ships caught fire, and the fire ignited an oil slick, but the Atlantic Empress caught the worst of the collision. The Atlantic Empress was towed away from land, and it burned for 2 weeks before it sank. In contrast, the fire aboard the Aegean Captain was extinguished, and the vessel was towed to Trinidad. Despite the enormous volume of oil released during the accident, the spill caused very little environmental damage to the beaches on nearby islands. Winds pushed most of the oil out to sea, where it dispersed. However, 27 sailors died during the accident. The Ixtoc 1 oil spill, 1979. Mexico's Ixtoc 1 accident released up to 140 million gallons of crude oil into the Bay of Campeche between June 1979 and March 1980. Due to the uncertainty surrounding how much oil was released during the Deepwater Horizon disaster, some sources rank the Ixtoc 1 accident as the second worst oil spill of all time. The spill began with an explosion aboard the Ixtoc 1 platform, which was drilling exploration wells in 164 feet, about 50 meters, of water. The explosion was caused when the drilling mud failed to circulate, resulting in a buildup of oil and gas in the pipe. When workers attempted to remove the drill so that material could flow back down the pipe and plug the hole, a slurry of mud, oil, and natural gas rushed up the pipe and bypassed the blowout preventer, which failed to work. When the gases came in contact with whirring motors at the surface, they ignited. Somewhere between 126 million and 140 million gallons were released into the southern part of the Gulf of Mexico over the next 9 months, and some of this oil washed up on the beaches from the western Yucatan Peninsula to southern Texas, which resulted in hundreds of millions of dollars in lost tourism revenue and reduced commercial fishing in the region for as many as 5 years afterward. BP's Deepwater Horizon Oil Spill, 2010. The largest accidental oil spill in history began in the Gulf of Mexico on April 20, 2010. After a surge of natural gas blasted through a cement well cap that had recently been installed to seal a well drilled by the Deepwater Horizon oil platform. The gas traveled up the rig's riser to the platform, where it ignited, killing 11 workers and injuring 17. The oil platform capsized and sank 2 days later. Before the well was capped several months later on September 17, some 134 million gallons of oil were released, according to the findings of the U.S. District Court, and about 2,100 kilometers, 1,300 miles, of the U.S. Gulf Coast from Texas to Florida were coated with oil. Some sources suggest that the amount of oil released was much higher, perhaps as much as 206 million gallons. In the lawsuits that followed, the oil company BP, which was deemed to be the responsible party, paid $65 billion in compensation to people who relied on the Gulf for their livelihoods. The Persian Gulf War Oil Spill, 1991. The world's largest known oil spill was not an accident. On August 2, 1990, Iraq's leader, Saddam Hussein, ordered the invasion and occupation of Kuwait with the apparent aim of acquiring that nation's large oil reserves, canceling a large debt Iraq owed Kuwait, and expanding Iraqi power in the region. See the Persian Gulf War article for more information. The United States amassed a coalition of British, French, Egyptians, Saudis, Syrians, and others to dislodge the Iraqis. After a massive air and ground campaign in January and February 1991, Iraqi forces retreated, but in the process they ignited hundreds of Kuwaiti oil wells, which burned for months. In a bid to deter the coalition from landing Marines and other amphibious troops in northern Kuwait and southern Iraq, Iraqi forces released hundreds of millions of gallons of oil from Kuwait's Sea Island terminal into the northern Persian Gulf before the end of hostilities. Some sources estimate that between 380 million and 520 million gallons were poured into the Gulf. Oil spills have left a lasting impact on our planet and the ecosystems that depend on it. These are just some of the biggest oil spills in history, and each of them had a devastating impact on the environment and local communities. As we continue to rely on fossil fuels, It's important to remember the devastating consequences that can occur when things go wrong. We hope this video has shed some light on the biggest oil spills in history and the importance of protecting our planet. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel for more content like this.